Okay, so we'll start with the webinar, which is a demo on new capabilities of Signature. I'm Shruti Vishnupurikar, and I'm handling the marketing part for Signature. And we'll be discussing and giving a demo on all the new features which are latest released in last release and the release which was done in May. So if you're able to hear me, that's good. If not, please type it in the chat box so that I'll be able to know about it. Fine. So we'll start with a simple electronic signature demo. This is the dashboard, as we all know. We'll just choose a file from here. Yeah, so we will just take a sample NDA here. The new feature we have here is a document category. We can select if it is a NDA, if it is a HR letter, which is offer letter, onboarding letter, engagement letter, or if it is a NDA, if it is a statement of work order, or whatever it is. So we can just select a non-disclosure agreement here. We can write a description like this is a sample NDA for Mr. Now I can attach a supporting document with this email. This is a new feature which we have come up with. So we can either upload it from a local drive, a Dropbox, or a Google Drive. So currently we'll do it from a local drive. Let's say this is a supporting document, which is a PDF. If I want to see, preview this document, I can preview it from here, or else if I want, I can delete it from here. I'll select the signer. I'll select observer here. Now, another feature which we've come up with is import of bulk signer. So if you want to import a number of signers, you can download a sample here, which shows in what format the contacts have to be. So like this, the contacts have to be in this format with a name, email, country code, and mobile number. I specifically created a file, a bulk import file for the demo. So I'll just import this. Yeah, so this is it. So if you want to send a particular document to n number of contacts, you can bulk import the sample, putting all the contact details of the signers in that. So I'll do save and next. Okay, so a few things here we have come up with new is these all fields, additional fields. So initially we just had a e-signature placeholder, but now we have additional fields like initials, like name, your date, the location from which you are signing, then there's title, your job title, and your company name. So I'll just put a placeholder here for myself. And if I want to add a initial here, I can do it. I can put my name here. If I want date, if I want location, title, your company name. So I'll just select a title here. Let's see. I'll select company name also here. One more thing which we have come up in the new releases, where you can add a comment. Like let's say if I want my signer to know about a particular thing on in this document. So if I want something which is to be known, like I want him to check the date here, let's say. So I can add a comment here. And I can just write a comment here. Please check date, something like this. Or anywhere in the document you want to add some comment and you want the signer to know about it or to get aware about it, you can just add a comment here. Okay. So the review page, we have added two more things here. You can just add a signing due date and a reminder here. So these two things are append verification QR code. So if you enable this option, then after the page, like the document, of the document has 5 pages. So if you append a verification QR code, you will get a 6 pages document on which the last page of the document will have a QR code of that particular document with its document ID. So if I enable that, I'll get a 6 pages document with this QR code, and later on, using the QR code, I can verify the document. We'll see how that is done. Next is remove signed document from signature. So if I just enable this option, then an email will go to the signer with the document. But if he logs into signature account, he won't get access to this document, particular document. So he can just see the document in his email. It won't be there on the signature UI or signature application. So I'll just not click this because yes, I need the document in my application. So this all looks fine here, and I'll just finish it. Now here we have added few more things because I've selected particular one signer. If you have multiple signers here, then we also have an option here of remind each signer. So if we have multiple signer, like let's say we have 5 signers in a particular document, so we can particularly send a reminder to each of the signer. So because I have selected only myself as the signer, I'm getting a sign option. One more interesting thing which we have added to this release is we can verify the document. Like if I upload a document, like let's say there are 2 signers, me and Yogesh sir. So I upload a document I send him a document on his mail ID that this is the NDA which we both are going to sign, and it consists of these all terms and everything. So yes, he and me, we agree on that, and then I upload the document. But what if I change the document during upload? Like let's say Yogesh sir and me agreed on the document which is sent in mail, but on signature I changed the document. So I can verify the document which was discussed earlier in the mail. So let's say I'll just upload this. So this was the document which we had agreed on, and I have uploaded that document. So I just want to check whether the document is same and it is not changed with. So document to be signed and uploaded document. So this was the document which we had discussed, and this was the document which is upload, and the comparison result of both is the both files are same. So this is particularly done in a use case where 2 people agree to sign on a document in the email, but one of them tampers with it, or one of them changes some content, changes some rules, changes some terms in the document, and then uploads it. So the next user who is going to sign the document can verify it before signing it. So I'll just proceed it to sign. Now here I can also see the comments in the thumbnail section. I can see this is the place where I have to sign. The flag symbolizes that the place where I have to sign. And in comment section, you can see the comments which were added. So because I had deleted the comments when sending the document, I can click. I'll click here to sign. We've also added 3 new ink colors in this, which was there in the May release. So I'll just draw something, and yeah, if I want to add initials, I'll add initials from here. My name, job title, company name. Done. So this is how it looks when you want to sign with everything, like when you have the all additional fields, like which is initials, your name, your position, your company name and everything. So this is how it looks when you sign with this, and I'll finish it. So this is one more thing which we have added is the signing process. It shows everything like from the processing of the signing document in the blockchain after signing, and it shows also when you create a document. So I'll just continue. It shows all the activities that have happened on the document since I've signed the document. The signing of the document using unique private key, creating unique hash value, then the timestamp of document into the blockchain, and storing of signed document securely onto signature server. Okay. So that's it. Here now few more things which we have added here is like if I want to preview the document, I'll preview the document here and I can check the legality of my signature. So this is a very important use case in terms of hardware sign and certified sign. You can check the legality of the signature here. So if I click on the signature, the signature properties are shown. Yes, the signature is valid, signed by Shruti Vishnupulkar using e-signature. This is my mail ID, the time, the location, and document not tampered. The timestamp, the verification timestamp. This is particularly valid when you're signing using a hardware sign or a certified sign. So it shows all the signing hierarchy, like who has issued the signing certificate, who has the person who holds this certificate, and who has signed the document. So particularly valid for the certified sign and hardware sign. Now, if I see the document, as we said, we had put on a QR code, append QR verification code. So this is the last page which is generated when I click the option of append QR verification code. So I'm getting a particular QR for my document which is signed after signed. This QR is generated after the document is signed. So we will see how to verify using this QR code. Also, one more thing which we have added on this details pages. If at all, like let's say there's a third party who wants to see this document, we too are involved in that, but after signing the document, the third person also wants to see this document. So I can share this document to that person using two different options, which is share on signature, share by signature. So I can just put his mail ID here, like let's say I want to share this document to Yogesh sir. So I can just put his mail ID here and now he can access the document, access the not access, but he can see the document details page where he can download the document, see the document, see the certificate, or print the document. If I want to share it via email, I can do that also. So here is a default email which is generated when I want to share the document. I'll send it to Deepika. So yes, access of a signed document on signature. So she gets this email and using this link, she can just access the document. We have few things added in the My Profile section also, which we'll see. This is which we've added in the latest release, which is signature aesthetics. Now, every time you sign with signature, if you enable this, then you'll have signed with signature. So this is like a proof that this document is signed using signature platform. So if you enable this, you'll be able to see a sign on your document like this. Few more things which we have added is the document archival duration till which how many years or how many years you would like to days, months, years you would like to have the document in your signature application after it is signed. So you can just keep it 8 years, keep it 20 days. If you don't want to clutter much, you can just keep it 20 days or something like that. So I'll keep it 10 years for now. You can also add a primary and a secondary mobile number, for your account. So if you want a OTP to be delivered on the second number, which is the secondary number, so you can just click that also. One more thing which we have added is the subscription details. So you, if you are a free trial user to signature, you will be able to see all the subscription details of yours, like what all services you are offered with, which type of signatures you can use to sign the document, the Aadhaar sign which is left with me, these number of Aadhaar sign were assigned to me, these many are left with me, how many live signature can I do till now. So all the subscription information, if you're upgrading yourself to a paid plan, you'll be able to see all the services which are offered in a paid plan. Also, one thing which we had discussed, if we want to just purge the document, like let's say as we discussed, we want it in only the email and not in the signature application. So I can do that also. I'll just show you a demo of how it is done. So I'll just okay, so remove signed document from signature. I can just click this and I'll finish it. And now once the document is signed, I'll be able to see the document only through my email and not through the signature application. So this is the signing process happening. This is a very unique thing which we have done, so that every process which is done can be seen here. So I'll get a mail here, a mail notification that this document is being signed, and I'll be able to access the document only through using my mail ID, not through the application. So here are the mail IDs, and I can see the view document option from here. Another thing which we have done is in the contacts. Now, if you're trying to add a contact, like let's say if you're trying to add a contact with some name, which is Anil Chhabra, let's say we have somebody called Anil Chhabra, and his email ID is anil@mymail.com, something like this, mmymail. So here it won't accept if the mail ID, the domain is not correct. Phone.com, let's see. Yeah, so it won't accept a mail ID which is not with a which is not with a domain, which is with a disposable email address. So it won't accept an email address which has these type of domains. If it should have a valid domain only, let's say like this. So a valid email address like this, it will be, so okay, contact already exists. Fine, so it will only accept the email address which has a validated domain, and it won't accept any email addresses with the disposable email addresses like Yocmail and everything. another thing which we have new is we can just just import the contacts using Office, Salesforce, Zoho CRM, which we're still not live yet, but in a few days we'll be able to do it. But yes, this feature we are going to add on. Also, if somebody has to register on signature, he will have to, use a valid email address only. He won't be able to register using this disposable email address. One more thing which we had done, yes, we were talking about the QR code. So the document which we have completed signing, we had a QR code. So this is purged. The document is purged. I won't be able to access the document. As I said, the document will be available for me to see only through my email. So I can see the document from my email only. If I have just removed the document, purged the document, I won't be able to see it from here. The action is purged here, so it is removed from signature right now. So in particular cases where you don't want to see the document on application and want to access it through only your email, so you can select that option in that case. One more thing which we have done is verification of document. As we discussed on this, in this particular document, we had this QR code generated on the last page when we had selected or enabled the option of append QR code verification. This is very interesting feature. Like if somebody has signed the document and let's say I purged this document from signature and I have a hard copy of this document. Now what is there with me is this document ID. If I have a hard copy of the document, or if also I have a soft copy of the document and I'm still not able to know who signed it, where signed it, and how, all the details of the document. So if I want to externally, just like let's say I don't know anything about signature and I don't know anything who signed it, when signed it, or what is signature, anything, but yes, I'm a third party to signature and I just want to verify this document. So I can select this document ID. Because I have appended a QR code verification on this document, I can just select this ID. You have this option, verify document on the website. Anybody who's not on signature, who's a user to signature, who's not a user to signature, who's a guest user, anybody, if he has this document ID, can verify the document. So few options here to verify the document. If you can just upload the document, you have a soft copy of it, you have a document ID, you have a signed document hash, which is there on the details page, signed document hash. This, if you have this, if you have the blockchain hash, which is this, or only you just have the document ID, I can verify the document by just putting that ID here. Another thing which you can do is using a QR code. Like as I said, if we have a particular document in a hard copy and we are able to see the QR code on that hard copy, so I can just enable my camera here and I can display that hard copy, like display that document exactly in front of my camera and let that QR code be seen in this camera, and it takes me to the document details page. So I'll just verify this document. So I've got all these details about the document. Like I have not logged into signature. I'm nowhere logged into signature. I cannot see my account here, nothing. So I'm a third party to signature right now. And I just verified a document using a URL link, which is on website. And I can see all these details here. So if I want, I can print, I can download. I can download the unsigned document. Then what happened to it after signing process? I can download the certificate. I can download the document. I can see the history. I can see the advanced details, who were the observer to these documents. Yes, everything I can see on this document which has happened, even if I am a third party to this document using the only QR. This is particularly useful when documents are in hard copies and they need to be verified through by a third party sometimes. So this particular use case in that field. Yes, I think we have covered almost all the new features. We have a lot of improvements, a lot of new things which have come up in the new releases. But yes, these were all the interesting features which we have come up with latest releases. And any questions and all, you can please go and on ask me in the chat box. I'm available right now. Please also please give good feedbacks if you know if you want something to be for to be improvised or you want some clarity on something. So please ask that type of question. Our development team is really working hard to get these things done. So your feedback is also very important. Okay, we have a question here for the verification of document. Does the verifier needs to register? No. So he does not need to register. If he wants to verify using a QR code, he can just have the document ID and he can just use this verify option, which is on website. Any person can access this. I'll just click this button. I say verify now and it takes me to this page. And if I have the document ID with me, I have the document. If I also I have a hard copy of the document, which is appended with QR verification, I can verify the document. So I, as I said, I'll just paste here the document ID and I can see all this detail. So here I am not a user to signature. I am a third party to signature and I just want to verify the document and I can see all the details here. So anybody who is on the website and wants to do this can do this. There's no as such mandatory issue to be a user itself to sign on signature or to verify on signature. Any more questions? Yes, we one more question which has come up is what about API integration? So yes, we do have API integration. We have API documents which are we also get to a API demo in a couple of days or maybe a week. API demo for API users only. So yes, as and when you need it, will be available for you for, with the API document and the API demo also. Also, we have come up with a mobile app which has very good features to sign on the go. You can please download it from the Play Store and use it. It gives you the access to sign documents from anywhere, anytime. We have one more question. What all features we get in free version? Okay, so you can just go to the website here and if you see on the website, we have pricing plans here. So in the pricing plans, we have all the features which we have mentioned here will be accessible to the free trial users. So anybody who wants to purchase a plan, also wants to purchase a plan, would have to sign up for a free trial first, and then he can go for a paid plan. So in free trial, you'll be able to see all these, in the free version, you'll be able to see all these features. You'll have access to all these type of features. These are all the signatures which will be paid, and you'll be paying it as on demand whenever you want to sign at a particular time, so you can pay at that time. Any more questions, please, you can ask us. Also, if any feedbacks, you can give us in the chat box. Also, you can enter your feedbacks on the webinar itself in your chat box if you have some queries, if you feel something was unanswered or something was left in the new release, or if you're not clear about something, please let us know. Fine. I think we have these many questions coming up. We're still available if somebody wants to ask us a question at, you can type in at hello@signature.io, or you can particularly send me also a personal mail and we'll be able to answer all your questions. In the next coming days, we'll also have a new release with all good features coming in. We'll also take again a demo and a webinar on this. Yes, so we can end it up. Any more questions, you can please type in the chat box or on the email also. Thank you so much for attending the webinar, and we will come up with very new features in the next release, and I hope you all will be able to attend the webinar once again with the new features. Thank you so much.